jump a railroad train. Your kind of love drives a man insane. So look for me walking just any old way. Have a love. Oh,
So, hey, Evan Richards, have we got front of house? Like, can you hear the PA and everything? Oh, great. All right, just while everyone's sort of moseying in, I'd like to do some housekeeping, so to speak. That bloke there, don't sit down yet. Pete Chambers, ladies and gentlemen, has stuck around for the second show with his wife, Lisa, and Pete, MND Victoria, by way of Pete Chambers, are the recipients of tonight's proceeds. Now, there's a thing where you can go on MND Victoria's website and look at Pete's legacy, and there's a donate button there. Also, Pete Chambers on Facebook is unmistakably the Pete Chambers official page. There's a donate button there, or will be very soon. So, thanks for sticking around, man. But he loves his Pete loves music, and we just happen to be musicians, so it sort of works out well. We've done one show already tonight, and so we're going to try and get it right this time. It was great fun, and we're most appreciative of your support for MND Victoria, and like, thank you from the heart of our bottoms for coming along. There's people still getting drinks and everything, so I won't get the band up here just yet. But so far, there is a dinner for eight people hosted by me and chefed by a woman who's like an incredible chef. And Drina is going to do the cleaning. So all you have to provide is a house with a good enough kitchen, right? And we've currently got a bid of $5K for it, and everything goes straight to MND, right? So have a think about that. If you've got a house with a kitchen, oh, and you've got to buy the food too. Right, which is because you can't just sort of say, you'll create the menu. You can create the menu, but you can't just say for five, okay, we'll have like a crate of grange, 5 kilos of Wagyu with a marble score of 15, Sydney rock oysters, 9 dozen of them. If you want to buy them, we can prepare it and everything like that. And it'll be a hoot because we're just, I would look forward very much to that. And if you've got 6 of your friends or 7 of your friends together, we can have a really lovely night. So you got a top 5K though, right? Because that's our firm offer at the moment from one of our great supporters. Anyway, that's pretty much all the housekeeping. Apart from a chap I just mentioned then, Evan and Josh are doing audio and lights tonight, and Drina's on the door, Simon Myers runs the dump, the joint place, the venue, Roddy Gilbert's organising the filming, Howard Peter Aitken, my son, is doing the filming and the live streaming for everything, and Roddy's the technical producer on that as well, so along with the staff behind the bar. Would you give them all a hearty round of applause, please, for their support? How's that drinks queue looking? It's getting thinner, isn't it? We don't care? Joe, we don't care? No, we don't care. Joe Camilleri, ladies and gentlemen. Joe and I started playing together in the Falcons. The guitar player in the Falcons wasn't Michael Cristiano, but could have quite easily been. Our bass player tonight and every night, Mr. Paul Gadsby on bass and vocals. Michael sings as well. On the keyboards, Johnny Grant. Keyboards and vocals. On drums, cymbals and cowbell, Mr. Freddie Strokes.
Thank you very much.
You want to do something else? You call it. We had a perfectly good set list that just blew the lid off the dump in our first show. But of course, that's professional, right? And as we all know, professionalism, that's for amateurs.
We're going to kick it off with this beautiful song called, I don't get to play this song very often. It's called Into the Mystic.
I love that guitar feel, that's great.
We were born before the wind. Also younger than the sun. And our spirit was as one as we're sailing to the mystic. Hark now, hear the angels cry. Smell the sand, fill the sky. Let your spirit raise up high as we're sailing to the mystic. That way that far gone blow, you know I will be coming. Yeah, when that fire comes blow, I want to hear it. I want to rock your gypsy soul. Way back when the days of old, yeah, together we would roll into the mystery. All right, Willie. Together we would roll into the mystic. Come on in. Thank you very much, everybody. We didn't do this in the first bracket, you know, and I went out for just to get a little drink, and some guy punched me in the face. I just made that bit up. But he said, "What?" He said, "I'm just going to be waiting outside. Would you mind playing this song?" And I said, "He said I've only got 5 minutes to live. Would you mind putting it down? Would you mind doing it now?" So we're going to do it for the gentleman who's outside the gates, and it's called The Shape I'm In. We're all singing, and of course, we're all dancing. shape I'm in. Oh, baby, you got me in the shape I'm in. Oh, man. Oh, China Dime, you're such a killer girl. You had me up all night, but I could not get a look in. You gave me the business, baby, on and on. Oh, those big black eyes, and I wonder what's going on. Oh, baby, you got me in the shape. Everybody singing. Oh, baby, you got me in the shape. Oh, baby, you. Everybody sing. Oh, baby, you got me in the shape I'm in. Oh, yeah. Such a night, like a thriller. Yeah. I was going round and round, baby, because I'm out of my tongue. To hear just a little louder. Got me. Say it one more time, children. We all sing it. Oh, baby, you got me in the shape. Oh. Thank you very much.
Two saxophones.
Thank you very much, everyone. I thought I was only doing one show. So he's renegotiated.
He was off. He was halfway back to regional Victoria. I had to put out a ring of steel.
I know. I was outside the ring of steel. That was kind of... You know, I was able to sort everybody's problems out over a coffee. I'm sorry for you. But here's a song that was on the list yesterday when we were sort of rehearsing. And I never thought it would get a Guernsey, you know, because it's a... I don't even play it in the... I never play it. You know, it's one of those things. It was kind of one of the... It was the first song that sort of was a sniff of what was to come. And we were struggling. We had four albums out, you know. And they were really weird titles, like Don't Waste It. You know, that's a really weird title.
And
Whip It Out.
That's Whip It Out, yeah, that's great.
That one...
A very 21st century, that one.
Yeah, that was... And you know, we were struggling. We were at the bottom of the ninth, but it was great fun because we didn't need a hit record in those days. There were just people that would just be, you know, as Wilbur said in the first bracket, you know, there was, you know, Martinis had 350 people in it, but we could manage to put 700 people all eating pizzas at the same time because... If you came to see the show, you'd have to have some food that went with it.
So we play to 5,000 people a week, right? And then when the album came out, we'd sell 5,000 copies, which is great, you know. But
anyway, we kind of went from we were manhandled from record company to record company, and so this was the start of something that ended up being. The song that we played, you know, I hadn't written any songs really. I was playing in a band called the Placco Brothers, and that was kind of like a funny it was an R&B rockabilly country and western thing, you know, there was some talent there, but it was still harnessed, Joining the Falcons, we had a great songwriter in Wayne Burt, and he had a fistful of great songs. And to this day, every time I see him, I apologize for ruining his songs. This next song was my first opportunity to write something for the band, and and everyone contributed, and it was kind of really and playing it. In the first bracket was just it was so much fun. I normally don't play I don't play this instrument, but I forgot to put the, you know how you have the, you know, the marker where you I could put the marker, so I'm going to keep my head down. I know it's going to sort of blinded by the light. But this is called So Young, So Young.
We've got them in a spin, and we don't mind sticking the slicker in. wrong cover. And we don't mind sticking the slicker in. Ooh yeah, you say it's time, babe. We got them hanging on string. There's no time for compromising. We got that killer thing. So young, so young. So young, so young. So young, so young. So young, so young.
Cha-cha-cha.
Thank you so much. Thank you very much. It was nice to hear a few of you singing along. That was kind of cute. This is an Arthur Alexander song. I've been doing this for a lifetime. I first heard this on a Zydeco record, and then I tracked it down, and it was written by the great Arthur Alexander. It's called You Better Move On. Goes like this. One, two, one, two, ready. Well, you asked me to give up the hand of the girl I love. You tell me I'm not the man she's worthy of. Well, who are you to tell me who to love? Oh, that's up to her and the Lord above. You better move on.
You better move on.
Oh, you better move on.
Better move on.
Well, I know you can buy her fancy clothes and diamond rings, but I know she'll be happy with me without those things. Still, you beg me to set her free. My friends, that will never be. You better move on, you better move on. Now I don't blame you for loving her, but can't you understand, man? She's my girl. I'm never gonna let her go. Get my man, cause you asked me to give up the only love I ever had. Maybe I would, but that's up to her and the Lord above. You better move on. You better move on. You better move on.
Did I'm
So,
Joey, that's really groovy. And what Joe didn't mention about So Young is it's the first song he ever wrote, and it eventually got covered by Elvis Costello and Frankie Goes to Hollywood. So there. See? Well, see?
Yeah. Ah, fooey. Ah, fooey. Ah. Fooey. This is the thing about playing the same gig, you know, I don't know how comedians do it, because you come in, good evening, ladies and germs. Oh my God, you are so fucking beautiful.
We don't need to.
I know, but that's how I feel.
It's a different audience, see?
Yeah, I know, but we've done the show.
They're much better than the first audience.
Oh, shit, yeah.
Ah, yeah.
I look around and you're much more sophisticated.
That's what you call in show business, a low ball.
You're bright. Those cats were, you know, they were low rent. Those early show people.
Compared to these guys. I mean, you guys are going to... Can you stand up for a minute? Just for 1 second. That's good. Sit down, will you, please, immediately.
That's a seventh inning stretch if you've ever been to an American baseball game. That's good. That's enough stretching.
Okay. Now, this is kind of... No, wait a minute. This is a very beautiful song, and I don't want to ruin it. I ruined it in the first bracket.
No, you didn't. But,
well, I kind of ruined it.
You did not.
I kind of did.
He didn't. They were there for the first. The Chambers was there, but they were there for the
first
stage.
I know, but, they know nothing about music. Okay, let's get it straight. So,
don't get him started on Neil Diamond, all right?
Please don't mention Neil Diamond. Here's the thing. It's a beautiful song. I've got the lyrics here, and I thought I could remember them, you know, and because I don't do this song. This is kind of, it's my culture. But it's not my culture, you know, and I barely know other people's songs. So I'm going to sing this, and I'm going to sing every word. Well, I wonder why Sardines is written there.
Remember you were writing that just after rehearsal, you were hungry. That was part of your dinner menu.
This is the menu.
He drives to Shepparton to get cans of sardines. I'm not kidding. Right.
Anyway. So if you know the song, which I'm sure you do, and it's a sort of song that you sing to your lover, you know, in many different ways. You know, sometimes you say, give it a couple of weeks. Sometimes you do all kinds of different things. But when the song is playing and, it's on the jukebox, you've kind of slide the needle down on the groove.
Ah.
And,
is that what you're calling it?
And then all of a sudden, you know, just...
Whoa!
I'm not taking it any further than that. Because I've got... This shirt's got no back.
It's one of those tear-away ones.
So, sorry, Van. There's a beautiful Van Morrison song, and it's called Have I Told You Lately? You know that song, girls? Okay, so, do you know all the words? I'm in trouble. Okay, let's see what we can do with it. And please sing along with us, because it'll be just a lot of fun if we can do it together. And all right, let it go. Let it rip, sweet prince, man of mystery.
One, two,
Just one more time, just one more time, one more time. Yeah. There's that sweet soul music coming to you. It's coming on. It's coming on strong. I just gotta say one thing. Have I told you lately that I love you? Have I told you there's no one but you? Fill my heart with gladness, take away my sadness. Here's my troubles, that's what you do. For the morning sun and all its glory makes a day with hope and comfort too. Fill my life with laughter, makes me feel better. Here's my trouble, that's what you do. There's a love so divine, and it's yours and mine. And at the end of the day, we give thanks and praise to the one that I told you lately that I love. Have I told you there's no one above you? You fill my heart with gladness, take away my sadness. It's my troubles, that's what you do. And at the end of the day, we give joy, hope and praise to the one. Have I told you lately that I love you? Have I told you there's no one above you? Fill my heart with gladness, you take away my sadness. Is my trouble, that's what you do. Take away my sadness, oh, you make me feel better. Is my trouble, that's what. Have I told you lately? Give it a couple of weeks. That I love you, 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 you,
right.
Thank you.
It's really good
with the
bright lyrics.
I know, it's better with the lyrics, you know.
And by the way, it wasn't sardines. It was sadness. That's what he'd written.
I don't know. I think a rewrite's kind of good, don't you think? Fill my heart with sardines. You make me feel better. Ease my troubles. That's what you do. Okay, we're going to get young Paulie up.
Yeah, let's do it. That's the two horn thing. That's how really we started, you know. Back in probably 1976, I sat in with saw this guy playing saxophone. I thought, hang on, wait a minute.
Wait a minute.
And then that's when we kicked it off. In fact, the horn I'm playing tonight, and I've played for most of my, I've poured my heart and soul through this over many years. And I purchased this from Joe Camilleri. I think he charged me $600 for it, even though he only paid $525.
Hey, wait a minute, inflation, okay? yeah, you know, like wogs and cash.
All right, here we go.
Which one?
Ah.
On the bass and vocals.
One, two,
and this is the Honey Dripper! Everybody give yourself a hand, that's all right. Yeah. Say it one more time, say it one more time. Yeah, that's right. Come on. Well, I say bomb. The Honey Dripper. Oh, he's a killer, the Honey Dripper. Cause he's something sweet, he's hot, he's mean, he's a solid old cat. Oh, really? Yeah. Another hip cat. He jumped and he tripped, he flipped and he flopped. He kicks and he swings, baby. He's a hound child, Jake that cat. He digs that lick, he digs that beat. You get knocked out right off your feet. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. That cat can jam and rip and swing a hot lick back the way.
the honey dripper. Boy, 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 boy. He's a ripper. The honey dripper. Boy, 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 boy. Swing it out, swing it out, swing it out, out. Swing it out, swing it out, swing it out, out.
Wilde, everybody.
Thank you, man. Thank you.
What a horn player. Hey, I'm trying to do my best not to play the songs how we played them before. We're doing a really good job.
Yeah, yeah.
We've got no idea where it's going now. But we started off with this song. Let me just ask the band if we played it. I'm not sure.
No, we haven't. Not the second set. If the one we started with in the first set is the one you're asking about, we haven't played it in the second set as yet.
Okay. What about
this? Not to say it's not a wise choice.
Okay. I was thinking more of the ninth song.
No, hang on. can I just say, because one of my great memories of the Falcons, when we went around the world in 1980, we played at, we played Switzerland and and London and stuff. But we eventually ended up at the Oakland Coliseum in the Bay Area of San Francisco, the home stadium of the Oakland Athletics, for a Bill Graham Day on the Green. And a favour to our publicist, who used to work with Bill Graham, they put us on the bill with, amongst others, Journey, Cheap Trick, Black Sabbath and Molly Hatchet, right, at 9:30 in the morning, and they hated us because this is the first song we played.
Well, that's true, but...
later on, we got them back, though, didn't we?
I don't know if we ever won them back.
Yeah, we did, because we started playing tough, you know.
I became tough, you know. I was much
taller.
You were tough. I was fucking 6 foot tall.
It was.
I was a 6 footer.
You came up to here.
Mind you, it was a Collingwood 6 footer. Okay. Anyway, so there's Willie's right, 9:30, and the stadium was full, and
65,000 people.
We're at a decent age. I can see some white bait out there. Right, I can see a lot of white bait, and I
don't know what is white.
That means you're over 60.
Checking. I just want to keep up.
I wish I could dye my fucking hair, there's no value. I know. Well, thank you very much. Come over here, baby. Give us a kiss. Give us a COVID kiss. Come over. You.
Wow, Mo. Down. Anyway, get down.
So.
Here come the girls.
Well, he started it, so I got to have to finish it. So as Wilbur said to the audience before, I was called the Angry Ant, and I was souped up, I was souped up for the gig. We had two gigs that night. We're playing the Coliseum, then we're playing at my father's place. I think it was in
a Bill Graham thing.
It was kind of a club, right? And you probably know this story, but there's a whole bunch of Mexicans. I don't even know why Mexicans like Black Sabbath, but fuck me dead. And tell me this, all the white bait here, tell me this, because if you're younger than 60, you probably don't know, you wouldn't give a shit. But if you're older than 60, do you go to a gig with a shit bag? Do you carry a shit bag so you can throw it at the band? Because
yes.
We got the shit bag.
I remember they threw baseballs and money, quarters.
They hit the late John Power
with
a coin. And then I, of course, being the idiot that I am, I said, is it any wonder your parents lost the Vietnam War?
Oh.
1980, the United States.
The wound, it was still an open wound then.
You reckon? We thought they'd thrown everything they had at us already.
And
they had other stuff.
All the stuff they had for Cheap Trick was... I did that. I did those bands a favour. So it all came flinging at me. And then, of course, to top it off, I said to the Mexicans, I'll have you on one at a time, And I couldn't, I'm a vegan vegetarian. Well, a bad vegan. I'm not even a vegetarian anymore. I'm a sardine guy.
You're a man of peace, but they wanted you to be pieces.
Yeah, they wanted me in pieces. And that's true. So, of course, I had one great line left. Was I said, if your parents knew how lame you were, they would have killed you in your sleep. And then I got everything else that was kind of that wasn't required. So everything came at us, but we stuck it out.
The Falcons' finest hour, Joey.
That was, it was sort of an interesting thing. But if you can imagine that kind of concept, those bands, and we're going to play this song. You can see why they were a little bit sort of on the, a little bit more like that. This is called Hit and Run, everyone.
One, two. One step,
baby, don't look back. Oh, my, 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 yeah. Hit and run. You gotta keep footing, running high. Cause it's gonna give it you. You gotta keep a one step, baby. That's all you gotta do. It's a lost weekend again from the hit and run. You keep it running, baby. For confusion, just hit and run.
Hit and run.
You gotta keep putting, putting, running high. Cause it's gonna get you. And we all sing it like this. Sabbath, Cheap Trick, Journey, Molly Hackett, I still got the t-shirt. You gotta keep footing, footing, and running and hiding, cause it's gonna get, you gotta keep one step, baby, quick step, girl, you gotta keep footing. From the hit and run. You
One more time, Wilbur Wilde, everybody.
Hey, thanks. I like playing the saxophone. Dr. Jolly told me 56 years ago that it had helped with my lungs. It was good. I had bronchitis, and he said, hey, maybe play a wind instrument, kid. He didn't smoke. I got into trouble for telling a story that he smoked, but he didn't smoke. So anyway, who knew? Who knew? Is that it?
That's it, isn't it? Well, if you ever... That's in the wrong key. Oh, that wasn't very good, was it? I thought I'd be really bright there. Well, I'm not doing it.
No, you got to do it. You got to. You've started. You've kind of got to commit to it.
I've lost it. I can't find it. How does it go? Good night, everybody. Well, if you ever, that's right, change your mind, believe it, baby, leave a mirror. All right, bring me all your love, bring it home. Bring it on. You better bring it on. Guitars. Thank you.
Well, maybe I will bring it to me. Bring me your love. Well, bring it on. I think, Willie, you should do that song when we go.
Yeah, okay, yeah, yeah.
This is kind of, this next song is, I've never played this song this before. I mean, I heard it on the radio.
So you know it.
I kind of know it. We all know it. And, but the interesting thing from a saxophone point of view, this is kind of like the one note samba, you know, and it really is a one note samba.
Like two saxophones.
It's called Let's Stick Together, everybody.
One, two.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you very much, everybody. What about introducing the members of the band?
Once again, which way do you want me? You want me to go in a certain direction? Because I've got a...
No.
Okay. Behind me, and a dear musical friend of many years, Mr. Paul Gadsby on bass and vocals.
Thank you.
Also, that caveat goes for every other member of the band, including Joe, dear musical friend. Michael Cristiano on vocals and guitar. Oh, yeah. Sorry about that. Nothing wrong with Michael. John Grant, who I've known for, like, centuries, on keyboards and vocals. And Freddie Strox, we met on a bus. No, he didn't. We met on the Heat of the Night tour in 1970, at the end of 1975 in Canberra. And the Hooks had backing vocalists Dan Robinson and Mary Took. And I'm still friendly with Dan Robinson as a result of that too. And still friendly with Freddie. Freddie from the Sky, like we met the Skyhooks, right? He played with heaps of other bands, including the Falcons.
Yeah.
But let's do a little thing.
Let's do that.
Okay, so a little sing-along, and I'm sure you'll know all the words, so I expect...
You will sing along.
So take it away, Michael.
How are you doing, Fred, my boy?
He said, tell me, Freddie, are you playing the same old place? I said, I'm actually doing a gig at the Memo. Yes!
I asked him all about himself. And he said that he was married with a kid. Oh, showed me a picture of his wife,
spread eagled upside down.
We talked about all those things we did. Now that all my friends are getting married, yes, they're all going home. They're all staying home on the weekend. Like I'm the one that's always left behind.
You're always left behind.
Sometimes I feel like I've just left school. Wonder if I'll ever grow up.
Why don't you grow up?
Or maybe I'm the only fool. Now that all my friends are getting married.
You're trying to sing it by yourself.
But I'm all caught up with this magic. Oh, 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 yeah, I'm all caught up with this fun. I'm all caught up with this music. Oh, maybe I'll never have a son.
I guess they've all settled down.
They're all doing what they're told.
Oh, oh, oh.
Fabulous. $500,000 Freddie, feel good.
Thank you very much. Thank you. Hey, I'm getting a standing ovation. I don't believe it.
And he gets, he's a really good renovator too. So if you need a deck built or I'm not kidding. Oh, same with Starkey. And Sherl, of course, was a chippy, you know. What is it with the hooks?
Yeah, you're right.
Starkey refused to be called a chippy, though. Just, he refers to himself as a master craftsman.
Oh, yeah. Hey, we got just time for one more song. So, I know what you're thinking.
We started a bit late.
I don't care. This is show business. Okay. So we're going to, you know, it depends on what you do, really. It, you know, like, now here's the thing. I sang the song before in the first time round.
Right.
And I think, I think I did a pretty good job.
Is that the one with sardines in it?
No.
No.
Well, we could put sardines in this.
It's up to you.
I know. So here's the thing. Now, this is a Rolling Stones song, and we all know and love the Rolling Stones. And I'm going to try to do my best impression of Keith Richard. But I left the needle at home. So, here's the thing: we're all going to have to sort of, you've been sitting on your keister for far too long. So everybody has to. While we're setting up the tempo, everyone has to stand up and everyone has to do kind of things that I will suggest. All right, let it roll, gentlemen.
One, two, three,
everybody get on up. Everybody get on up. Yeah, yeah. Everybody clap your hands. Yeah, yeah. All right, yeah. Oh, yeah. With me.
Lord, I miss you.
Everybody with a been waiting for you. Everybody sing it. Everybody, everybody, say it loud and clear. Clap your hands. Oh, I've been howling in my sleep, baby, you know it's me. Lord, I miss you. I've been waiting on the phone, waiting for your call. Lord, I miss you. Thank you very much, everybody. Good night.
And Steph and Camilleri. Michael Cristiano. JG. Mungo Zoo. John Grant. Freddie Storms. Freddie Feel Good. Paul Gadsby. Long Tall Paul. Thank you so much. My name is Willie Wilde, and you have assisted a very great cause tonight, and we hope you've dug the gig. Thank you so much. Usually this guy is halfway back to regional Victoria, but I know for a fact he's worn his heavy chains tonight. He's got his winter chains on for that ascent up to Mount Hotham.
We haven't rehearsed this song, so we got to do a gospel thing.
It's in a key of C.
We need those claps. We need those claps. Yeah. One, two, one. Too slow for the last number. Let's lift it up a little, Freddie.
One, two, three.
up my walk from the dark end of the street to the bright side of the road.
Yeah. All right.
Into its life we're born. Sometimes just don't know why. Time seems to go by so fast with a twang. Help me sing my love. Help me share my love. From the dark end of the street to the bright side of the road. Blow your horn, Willie. Blow your horn. The Troublemakers, everyone. On the bright side of the road. On the bright side of the road. On the bright side of the road. On the bright side.
Thanks for the management. Trina, Espires, Rod Gilbert, Alicia, once again, thanks you guys, Mr. Richards and Josh, and Pete Chambers. It's the whole deal. So MND Victoria, Pete's Legacy, and also Pete on Facebook, and just it's been a guess. Quite overwhelming that this is one of our first gigs back. And have played in front of an audience like you guys has been just mighty.
So thank you.
cross it with your